Well, welcome to the National Exhibition Centre in Birmingham, the 1993 World Gymnastics Championships, and we will be bringing you over the next 3 hours live action from the National Arena. 3 hours of the women's all-around individual competition. Alongside me, Eurosport's technical expert from the event of gymnastics, Hayley Price. Hayley, you've been in this position 3 times before. What's going through the girls' minds now?
I think the worst part of any international competition, especially World Championships, is when you actually march into the arena. Their nerves are probably all over the place, butterflies in the stomach. As soon as you get going, you're well into the competition and concentration sets in. But the actual march on with a big crowd is pretty hair-raising.
Well, it really is a big crowd, 11,000 capacity crowd in the National Arena. The atmosphere is very tense. We've seen some incredible gymnastics from the men in yesterday's all-around competition. And, of course, Vitaly Sherbo claiming gold there. And the big favourite, Hayley, for tonight must be Shannon Miller, the leader and, of course, the winner from the all-around competition, or qualification, I should say.
Yes, Shannon Miller is looking very, very good indeed. I've watched her in training 2 or 3 times, and she's working like clockwork, no mistake. In training even. Definitely number one choice for most people. Here we have the Japanese, we have the Canadian. Republic of Uzbekistan. Benedict
Everard, Belgium. There we have Everard of Belgium. So the introduction of the finalists. 24 have advanced through to the final from 103 at the beginning of the qualification.
People Republic of China. Those are your vaulters. Moving on to asymmetric bars.
And this is the introduction of the athletes for the first of the four rotations.
Lavinia Milosevic, Romania.
Milosevic, surely one of the favourites. Second in the qualification. Bronze medalist in the Olympics.
Dominic Dawes, USA.
And the surprise, possibly, of this competition in the qualification, Dominique Dawes.
Yes, Dominique Dawes has worked exceptionally well. She was probably the third choice to get into the finals for the American team. Kerry Strug was probably a bigger favourite to make the all-rounds, and she has actually got there first. Shannon Miller, again, the crowd behind her.
And she certainly is the favourite for this evening's competition. As we move on to the beam, the... There is Tatiana Lysenko, and really one of the darlings of the Barcelona Olympic Games, Lysenko.
Lysenko didn't have a very good beam in the qualifying rounds, very shaky beam, in fact, and let's hope she can get it together today. Not always the best piece to start on when the nerves are there, because the beam can often be the make and break of a competition.
Kristina Molnar of Hungary, one of the two sisters competing here. Yulia Yurkina of Belarus, her first international experience, and in the last of the group for the beam, Li Li from China, just 18 years of age. Well, they are the three groups of eight, the 24 finalists. As we prepare for the beginning of the women's all-around competition, 3 to 3.5 hours. And for those of you unfamiliar with the rules, a quick resume, Hayley.
Right, the rules have actually changed, and this is the first all-around competition where we're using the new rules. Just to briefly explain, the girls are now marked out of 9.4 for their exercises, and the tariffs in the vault have gone up so that, obviously, the vaults that were once considered extremely difficult are now much lower tariff than they used to be, and they're having to do even greater difficulty to get the 10 tariffs. Girls are awarded bonus marks of up to 0.1, 0.2 for the more difficult elements on each piece, making their score up to 10 if it's a perfect routine.
Well, each of the groups given time to warm up on the apparatus before the start of the rotation. And for the layman out there of the gymnastics, quite simply, it's my feeling that they were scoring one too many tens in Barcelona. So the judges of the Gymnastic Association have made the point score harder, but probably, knowing the world's best gymnast, they'll be scoring 10 in Atlanta again in 98.
It's all very new at the moment, so the girls aren't scoring tens as easily, and that was the idea, to reduce the amount of tens being scored, because there's so much excellent gymnastics and they've had to make it more difficult.
Well, as the girls prepare, Hayley, you've been in this position before. You've represented Great Britain in 3 World Championships, and of course you've been our own national champion. How vital is this warm-up and this preparation to the girls? And of course it's the beginning, right at the start of the competition.
The warm-up's very important, and also important to try and get the warm-up as correct as possible and not make big mistakes, because that obviously plays on your mind. If the warm-up goes badly, you're obviously under more pressure to compete perfectly. If the warm-up goes well, you're full of confidence and you're going to get a good result.
Well, this is the third day of competition here at the National Arena in Birmingham, just 7 miles outside of the city centre of Birmingham for all our viewers in Scandinavia, Spain and Portugal. And it really is a very interesting two-day qualification. Of course, the first position of the qualification for the all-round was Shannon Miller of the United States of America. Milicevic was second for Romania. Dominic Dawes, the surprise from the American squad, came in third. Gojian for Romania was fourth. And Li Li was fifth for China. So some interesting results. And of course, the story, I should say, of the gymnastics is, Hayley, no Tatiana Gutsu.
No, Tatiana Gutsu, we believe, has suffered some kind of minor breakdown. She's competed in an awful lot of competitions, and the pressure after Barcelona must have been quite tough on her. We feel she's revising new routines and she's preparing herself for a better result in her next major international.
So no Olympic champion, Tatiana Gutsu, and also no world champion of 91 in Indianapolis, Kim Semeskul.
No, Kim Semeskul also. It's not competing. Again, resting and hoping to get her act together for the next competition.
So, not all the world's top gymnasts here, but you can guarantee that this lady, Dominique Dawes of the USA, and her teammate Shannon Miller will give us a wonderful evening's skill and gymnastics. So the first competitor, Stella Ume, gets the first rotation and the competition underway for Canada, the 18-year-old from Toronto. The asymmetrics bars. Now, Stella had a good qualification, came in joint fifth position. An important start to her four rotations.
So we have the upstart into handstand. That's the full twisting giant. And again, straight into Katchev. Very nicely performed, good leg form, nice straight legs. Shoot over to handstand. And swing through, again keeping brilliant leg form here. No breaking legs, no bent legs, and a double twisting dismount.
Well, that's a very pleasing start for Stella Ume, a very strong and really quite powerful gymnast. Not of the mold of some of the very small and petite Romanians and Russian. The coach certainly happy with that. And Hayley, a good promising and confidence building start there for Ume.
Yes, she's one of Canadian's best gymnasts. She's working very, very confidently on all pieces and has done throughout the competition, also in training. The full twisting giant here performed with really, really good body tension, straight into the Katchev, good height. Certainly showing a lot of amplitude during this routine. Swing into the dismount. And a very good landing.
So Stella Ume for Canada waits for the first point score, and as our expert Hayley Price has explained, expect much lower marks. The point scoring system has changed considerably since the Barcelona Olympics of 92, the last major competition. Not all of the top stars here, but certainly one of them, and that is one of them preparing there, Lavinia Milicevic.
Some of the real gymnastic followers here might not have recognized she's had her hair cut off, which makes her look much older and a lot more mature. She's also working much more maturely, a big favorite with the crowd. Her bars here is a very good piece. She's probably a bigger expert on the floor, but she had a good competition in the qualifying rounds.
Well, second position there for Stella Ume. So that's a good start for the Canadian. Very early days. We're into the asymmetric bars in the first rotation, but one of the favorites is about to start her competition. Lavinia Milicevic, the bronze medalist in the all-around competition in Barcelona 1992. Just 14 years of age, but one of the few gymnasts that really could upset Shannon Miller.
Here preparing, concentrating for the start of her routine. There we have the half turn into upstart on the low bar, flying back to catch the high bar. That's the full twisting giant. And again, into release and recatch. upstart, losing a leg slightly on that upstart. Into a Kachev. Two release and re-catches, very good. Into the double pike dismount, slight hop forward, but steady routine.
Well, Milicevic, who finished just behind Shannon Miller of the USA in the World Championships all around 2 years ago. Miller was sixth there, Milicevic was seventh. But Milicevic, like Shannon Miller, has matured and come on, not only in confidence, but in strength as well, and quite a good start.
Yes, quite a good start. Here we go into the upstart, into handstand, preparing for the next release and re-catch. That's a full-twisting giant. Full-twisting giant, and here, straight into the Ginga somersault. Swinging through, slight loss of legs there, bent legs on the bottom bar, that's a 10th, she'll get deducted for that. Into upstart, swing through into handstand. Building up for the dismount, which is the double pike back somersault.
Well, that is not, that's the next competitor on your screens there. Not Milicevic. Well, we'll have to wait for the score. There is quite a delay, and the competition rules state that the next performer will go. Rosalilia Galivia for Uzbekistan in the vault.
There we have the handspring front somersault in the pike shape with a half turn. Most of the girls now adding half turns into their vaulting because they have to get the extra bonus marks.
Certainly not looking too happy, reminiscent of the tears of Olga Corbett and many of the other female gymnasts there, but it's early days in this competition. Now here's one of the favorites, Tatiana Lysenko on the beam. We're moving round the three apparatus out of the four in this first rotation. Now Lysenko, of course, won a gold medal in the Olympics for the team.
Lysenko had a shaky start in the qualifying round, so she's looking for a good beam exercise. Again, a little bit older, showing the maturity and a little bit more artistry, which you don't see quite as often these days. That's backflip into three straight back somersaults. Very well performed. A big favourite with the crowd, this girl. That's the punch front somersault again, perfect landing. Corbett flick, obviously named after Olga Corbett. The full spin, which has to be included in all beam exercises, and quite often the move that even top gymnasts don't like doing, can quite often be the move they fall on. Nice jump sequence. Here, preparing for the dismount. Which is the round off, double back somersault, slight hop back on landing, but she'll be happy with that.
Well, the 18-year-old, now a little more matured, Tatiana Lysenko, gets off to a good start, and that certainly is a strong dismount. 9.712, that's the best score we've seen so far this evening, as Lysenko goes into first position. Milicevic scores 9.512, down into third position. So Lysenko, who's only in ninth position in the qualification, possibly saving a little bit extra for the final, and one of the girls that was really thoroughly entertaining indeed in that qualification, the surprise from the United States of America, Dominique Dawes.
That's a very high Kachev. She really swings well on bars, makes it look incredibly easy. That's a 1.5 twisting giant, quite unusual to see. Good form in the legs with that straddled upstart. Full twisting giant. Into the full twisting double back dismount, and she'll be pleased with that.
So the pressure already starts to build. Lysenko's had a good start on the beam, and Dominique Dawes, the 16-year-old American, has also started with a good routine on the asymmetric bars. And of course, all eyes will be on the teammate of Dawes, Shannon Miller, still to perform in this first rotation.
Here we have the swing to handstand, building up for the 1.5 twisting giant through shoot half turn. Earlier on, actually, in training, we had a Russian girl actually break her hand doing that movement, so it's not as easy as it looks. Full twisting double back, slight hop to the side, but a good solid performance.
Early days in the competition, 9.7. Lysenko with an excellent start on the beam. Very strong character. Well, we'll await the scores of Dominique Dawes. We'll watch the second vault of Galieva.
That's much better vault. She's performed the same vault again, which is the handspring front and the pike shape with a half turn. Actually marked out of 9.9, so it's a good tariff vault and much better performed than the first attempt. Good aggression in the run-up. And a much better landing. This is actually the girl who should have made the finals in Barcelona, but due to a mysterious illness, which we're not quite sure about, Gutsu took her place and became the Olympic champion.
Galieva goes into third position, and Dominique Dawes steals it away from Lysenko, 9.762. America are now in first position. Anya Portumbo of Cuba, and this is an interesting competitor and qualifier, Hayley.
Yes, Cuba really progressed in gymnastics, and this girl is showing a lot of good work. There we have the full twisting giant. The first of the Jaeger somersaults we've seen today. Kachev, that's two release and re-catches. Good content. Swinging through into handstand. And finishing with a full twisting double back somersault.
Well, another creditable performance for the Cuban Portumbo. And Portumbo came in 20th position in the qualification, so it wasn't a scrape. She really did qualify quite convincingly with the Canadian, the Belarusian, the Russian, and the Guatemalan behind her. So a possible new name getting her first opportunity and experience of world-class competition, and that's not a bad score at all. 9.612, and Portumbo goes into third position for Cuba. So early days, but it is full of surprises already.
This could be quite a breakthrough if she has a good competition for Cuba, because we haven't seen many girls up there in the top for some time.
Well, the standings so far, we're only halfway through the first rotation in this women's all-around competition. Dawes leads for the United States of America. Lysenko is second. The surprise, Portumbo, is in third position for Cuba. Galieva is fourth for Uzbekistan. And Milicevic, who many would have thought would have been leading, is down in fifth position for Romania. It is early days. We're trying not to get too carried away and excited in the commentary box here. And of course, all eyes are on that young lady just to the left of your screens there, wearing the white suit of the United States of America. The favorite, Shannon Miller, the best qualifier of the 24 finalists. We move into the group of Shannon Miller, and will the American cope with the pressure? We will have to wait and see as the girls take another warm-up in preparation for the second of the three groups of eight. And Hayley, surprising early start, or we're just maybe judging it a little too soon?
It really is difficult to judge. You've got obviously four different pieces, and some have stronger pieces than others. So when you've got the first round, it's very difficult to say what's going to happen. I think so far they've been good, consistent first rounds by everybody, no major mistakes. So it's going to be a very close competition.
It really will be very close. And well,
here we have Miller preparing for the warm-up.
just warming up, but the camera quite rightly focusing on Shannon Miller. We're getting a bit of a wrong title there, and wrong graphics, but it is Shannon Miller, the lady in the white suit with the blonde hair, and Miller was the silver medalist in the Barcelona all-around competition. Silver medal behind Tatiana Gutsu, who is not competing here due to pressure and illness. So by rights, that makes Miller the favourite. Well, we go back 2-3 years ago, the 1991 World Championships. Miller was down in sixth position there, and Milicevic behind her in seventh. Milicevic is down in fifth position so far in the first rotation, so the competition has been thrown wide open. Another one to watch out for, Gina Gojian of Romania, second in the European Championships to Tatiana Gutsu, so she could be a threat, but the leader is Dominique Dawes, a 16-year-old from the United States of America, and that may shake the nerves of Shannon Miller, who will be out in the next. Well, there's a good shot of the scoring. I hope it's a little more accurate than that. But the scoring, how many judges are we, and what exactly are they looking for, Hayley?
Okay, we have six judges around the floor area, and we take the average of the four. There you can see, actually, quite interesting. If anybody does shorthand, the judges actually work to a similar system. They have a system whereby each move has a special symbol, and obviously it takes them far less time to draw these symbols and to write down every move the gymnast is doing.
So we're about to start with the second group. 24 finalists, 2 days of qualification. Started off with 103, we're down to 24. The individual finals coming over the weekend. Chusovitina of Uzbekistan, her first vault of the first rotation. 17 years of age.
She actually scored a very good mark in the qualifying rounds with a 9.6, so she'll be looking to repeat that score, or even better it, we hope. That's the handspring front half in the pike position again, which we saw earlier on. Slightly better performed, better legs, and good landing distance. And 9.9 tariff. And here we see it again in slow motion. Perhaps lacking in height slightly, but very, very neat, and a good solid landing.
Well, Chusovitina, one of the Eastern European gymnasts given the opportunity to compete, so often kept out of the Russian team, so difficult, and the competition for the places in the Russian squad, very intense indeed. A new ruling here, only two competitors per country, but now representing Uzbekistan is guaranteed a place and her first taste at world-class competition, 9.625, and that's respectable. If you can do that on the second, certainly be good enough to break into the top three.
Something else which is different as well in an all-around competition, instead of taking the best mark of the two vaults, they're actually averaging the two marks. So they have to perform two good vaults to come up with a good score. They can't fall down on one and have one good attempt. They have to be two consistent vaults.
Second vault for Chusovitina.
Not such a good landing, actually better with the height and the flight, but the landing poor, slight deviation and slight loss of balance. It could be 1 or 2 tenths, possibly 3 tenths actually, for that poor landing.
Take a look again in slow motion, really looking for the flight off the horse there. And just quite clearly, as we've been pointed out, off balance, and a few tenths of point will be taken away there.
Good height, good length, but as you can see from that very good camera angle, that she's not in line. She's actually deviated to the side of the horse, and that can be anything up to a 0.3 deduction.
Chusovitina goes into fifth position, 9.581, and we are seeing very high scores early on in the competition here. But Dawes still leads for the United States of America as one of the favourites from Romania. Gina Gojian, second in the European Championships last year in Nantes. And so that was behind Tatiana Gutsu. So can she find that form again in the Worlds?
And it's a Yurchenko vault with a full turn. Very well performed. This vault actually is not the tariff it used to be. It has actually been downgraded because so many gymnasts are doing it. That was performed very well, so she should get a good score. Now marked out of 9.8 instead of 10. There we see very, very high flight, good distance, and no move on landing. It'll be interesting to see the score, as it's only marked out of 9.8. That was a very well performed Yurchenko vault.
9.7. Well, if she can just possibly pick up a few more tenths to get that divide, well, it's a good
start.
It's
going to be difficult to pick up more tenths.
So second vault for Gozhin, with America leading. This could quite easily put Romania into the top three. And again, more pressure on the favourite, Shannon Miller, still to perform.
Here we have the cartwheel onto the springboard. Oh, that was, oh, near perfect, near perfect.
No nerves or sign of any pressure from this young Romanian. Just 15 years of age, sixth in the all-around competition in Barcelona. Suffered a little from nerves there, but again, a very confident second vault indeed.
Oh, slight loss of form when we see it in slow motion. As you can see, it's quite difficult to for the judges to spot that. I didn't see that when it was actually performed initially. But very, very slight loss of legs, maybe 1/10. But I think that's going to be another 9.7. Very, very good height and good distance on landing.
Let's await the score. Gozhin goes into second position, 9.718. Dominique Dawes holds onto it, 9.737 for that second vault. And that's a very good start indeed for this young Romanian. And she's proving that that second position to the great Tatiana Gutsu in the Europeans about a year ago was no one-off. We move around once again.
Here we're moving on to asymmetric bars.
Fabrychanova, Oksana Fabrychanova of Russia. And again, another youngster that we haven't seen in international competition before, but been given an opportunity to compete. Just 14 years of age, Haley.
She's one of the youngest competitors. You have to be 15 within the year of the competition. She was 14 in March, so she just makes this competition. She's just won the Moscow World Stars, which is a very big competition held in Moscow where we have all the tops there. So she's doing extremely well and making a big impact on the sport.
Well, she was last but one in the qualification, 23rd. But, well, you have to say, she really does look tiny and so wee in comparison to some of the others. She won't let that affect her. A little bit of whistling from the crowd, obviously not agreeing with one of the point scores awarded. So not only a test for this young Russian, her first chance to possibly charm the crowd in this evening's competition.
We have a very confident start. There we have the Ginga somersault. Good legs, good feet. Unusual to see a full twisting jar the other way around on the bars. You can only do that if you're very small. She's working extremely tidy here. Showing precision throughout, and we're building up to the dismount, which I think was a double twisting dismount.
We'll take a look again at that dismount in slow motion. Very quick work. What a great example of strength and agility from the young 14-year-old Fabrychanova.
She seems to be pulling the stops out because she looked very nervous in training, having a few problems here and there. I think probably nerves and experience, a lack of experience, you know, being so young at the big championships. Here we see the giants again, done between the bars, which is very difficult if you're tall. Now the girls are working with the bars much wider than they used to, into the catchev. Change of direction, which is a special requirement on the asymmetric bars. And it is a double twisting, double back somersault. I thought my eyes were deceiving me.
Well, a promising start for the youngster. And as we pointed out earlier, suffering from nerves in the qualification, but with every time she takes to the floor, she settles and certainly lapping up the experience of her first World Championship. And at 14 years of age, well, let's hope that she sticks with it and could quite possibly be one of the favorites for Atlanta. Just 4 years away. But again, a youngster given the opportunity to compete due to the dividing of the state of Russia. Third position, 9.712. Well, Fabrychanova smiling underneath that little face, I think, as we move right on to one of the big favourites, Shannon Miller. Well, this will be interesting because in the qualifications, not half as many good scores had been seen by the silver medalist from the 92 Summer Olympics of Barcelona. So the big favourite, the leader after the qualification, now with her teammate leading in the final, Shannon Miller for the USA, her first performance in rotation one.
Shannon almost trains as though she's competing, so hopefully we won't see any mistakes here. She's very cool, calm and collected. That's the giant with a hop. Very difficult element. Giant full twist. Into the catchev. Showing an awful lot of difficulty here. And finishing with a double straight back somersault. Just a slight hop on landing, but nothing to worry about.
Well, all the elegance and strength that's become the familiar calling card of Shannon Miller for the United States of America. She's just 16 years of age, trains in Edmond, Oklahoma. Haley, is that the start that she was looking for?
That was a consistent start with an awful lot of difficulty. She'll be pleased with that. If you notice here, she does a giant with a hop, which is actually an E-rated element in the code of points, one of the most difficult that you can do on the asymmetric bars. She has two release and recatches. She does look slightly nervous, and her legs are showing slight lack of form, but nothing too difficult, nothing too bad.
Well, she picked up a bronze medal in Barcelona in this, the individual competition for the asymmetric bars, and none of the competitors here today would have bettered the score. So if she was ever to need a good start to a competition with all of the other competition really pulling out personal bests in this final, we will await the score of Shannon Miller very carefully and closely indeed. Wonderful grace and the finish there. 9.825. Well, Haley, she's done it. First position, and the scores seem to be getting higher and higher.
Well, we can certainly say she's pleased. That's the first smile I've seen all week. Having been there for 3 days, she doesn't smile an awful lot. And when you see a smile, you know she's pleased with that performance.
So Shannon Miller rises to the bait, and the pressure put upon the earlier competitors goes into first position. It's a very promising start also for the American team, with Dominique Dawes in second position and Gogia now lying third for Romania. It's early days in this competition, another three rotations to go, but the standard and the quality of gymnastics certainly getting higher and higher. And possibly the form book of the qualification is not the one to go by. The girls really rising to the moment.
When it gets down to the finals, everybody seems to pull out all the stops, and mistakes that have been made in previous rounds tend to disappear.
Well, the girls once again move around. And that brings the end of rotation one to the end. Very good start, as once again there will be a presentation and a march to the next set of apparatus. Then a short warm-up as we move to some pre-recorded highlights. Li Li for China. And our first look at the Chinese team on the beam.
Here we have a lift into handstand with a very unusual exit. Drop back onto the beam. Here we have the gymnastics series, two leaps, performed very well. Into an acrobatic series of a backflip and two straight back somersaults into the full spin. The Chinese are very elegant on beam and always look very artistic, making that jump look incredibly easy. They always show great amplitude, great form, and are very flexible, which makes them look very elegant. There we have the backflip across the width of the beam and circling underneath. Now that might look quite easy, but if you can imagine doing that on 10 centimeters wide, you'll appreciate it's not easy and it's a very difficult spin indeed. And the double back somersault to finish.
Well, no shortage of originality from Lili. And that score will be a very interesting one to watch from the judges. Some really incredible moves here. The crowd certainly enjoying every part of this routine from the 18-year-old. Of course, it's not possible to show you every part of the routine. We're going to wait the score of Lili. This was taped earlier during the competition. 9.837, the first surprise, first position for Li Li of China in the first rotation. Miller is in second. It's early days, a short commercial break, and we'll be back with more on Eurosport.
Eurosport Live.
Welcome back, and the results of the first rotation. Unfortunately, we had to show Li Li of China on tape delayed, but she has gone into first position. 9.837, just ahead of the favorite Shannon Miller for the United States of America, 9.825. The USA again in third position. Gojia is fourth, Fabrichanova for Russia is in fifth, and in joint fifth with Lysenko of the Ukraine. A good start for Portundo of Cuba in seventh position, and Strobovchava is in eighth place. Well, Shannon Miller thought she'd done just enough to clinch the lead early on. Four rotations and China are in first position. But a specialist on the beam, Hayley Li Li, Shannon Miller surely will be confident with her specialist apparatus still to come.
Yes, Li Li, it's one of her strongest pieces along with bars. So Shannon Miller has a floor exercise, which for her is extremely strong, and also her beam, which she very rarely falters on. So it's going to be a close competition.
So the girls once again given a short warm-up period as we move into the second rotation. This is live action from the National Exhibition Centre in the heart of the United Kingdom, Birmingham, in the middle of the West Midlands. And the Exhibition Centre, just 7 miles out of the city centre and playing host to the 1993 World Championships, is the National Arena. And the women's all-around final following the men's, and then the weekend will give us all the individual apparatus. But the first medals to be decided, and Hayley quite possibly the most coveted of titles to be collected, the all-around or overall title, as Rosalia Galieva for Uzbekistan starts the second rotation.
Galieva here to prove that she is a good gymnast, and although she didn't compete in the finals in Barcelona, will do well. There's a Katchev somersault. Slight loss of form in the legs there. She straddles over the bottom bar. Into the Jaeger somersault in the pike position. That's giant. Into the double straight, very good landing. There we see quite a lot of bent knees and very simple elements, and that's very debatable with the judges, whether they actually deduct or they call it a technical aid. Quite often judges can see it as a technical aid and other judges will deduct 0.1. Something that I think needs really to be talked about and a firm decision made. Again, it's a very high catch-off. Shoot over to the low bar. Here we see the slight loss of form. But the bars are so wide for the girls that it is quite often difficult not to bend the knees. Into the double straight dismount, very difficult dismount, with a perfect landing.
Chusovitina should be the next up, but Galieva for Uzbekistan awaits the score. She should go into first position because she's the first competitor of the second rotation. Well, we'll wait patiently. Often our camera teams in Birmingham will move on to the next competitor so we don't miss any of the action.
She looks a little bit disappointed with that routine. But 9.775, I mean, it can't be bad, but she doesn't seem too happy, but maybe she's just concentrating for the next piece.
Certainly one of those athletes that doesn't seem to show any emotion. Well, this lady shows lots of personality and lots of emotion when it's needed. Dominique Dawes, second position off the first rotation, and takes the beam in the second.
Starting there with a not a difficult mount, but a very elegant mount. Side split. That's the straddle pike jump, very difficult across 10 inches. 10 centimeters rather, if the beam was 10 inches, they'd be doing triple backs. There we have the gymnastics series, and that was a backflip into three consecutive straight back somersaults, getting bonus marks for that series of acrobatic skills. She's actually looking, although she's not making mistakes, she's looking very nervous facially. There we have the tucked front somersault. Very difficult jump. That was a side split jump with a quarter turn. Showing some quite original work on the beam here. And making it look exceptionally easy. Finishing with an acrobatic series of two backflips and a full twisting double back somersault.
Well, Dominique Dawes continues to find the consistency, which really is the name of the game in this all-around competition. Good hug there from the coach.
Yes, the coach has been with her all week. It's nice to see they've got their own coaches with them, and they're not relying on one coach for the whole team, who they're not always familiar with. There we saw the two straddle jumps across the beam again. Slight loss of legs here, but I think we'll forgive that for a series like this. Three straight back somersaults with a perfect ending. Again here losing the legs, but we see the full in, back out. Slight hop back, but she's going to be pleased with that performance.
Well, Li Li of China scored 9.875 to claim the lead in the first rotation. And Dominique Dawes was in third position, but this, her second routine, again, not looking to be as good as Li Li's 9.875, but certainly another good consistent score for the American.
Here, just checking that the bars are perfectly chalked up. That's one thing that gymnasts really like to check on. Everybody likes the bars a certain way. Some wear hand grips and some don't.
Oksana Chusovitina for Uzbekistan. Just preparing. Svetina. Well, she's in the top 10. And there's a score of Dawes, 9.775. Compute that with her score from the first rotation. And once again, Diana Dawes goes into first position, but she'll wait to see Shannon Miller and Lili, the two gymnasts ahead of her from the first round. As we should return now to the asymmetric bars and Chusovitina.
And she's ready to go. Quite an unusual dismount, usually done in the straddle position, there done in the tuck position. Oops, and that's the first big mistake of the championships. I think she was going for a stutz there, which is usually a move that we see on the men's high bar. Perfectly done in warm up and obviously very disappointed. She'll obviously lose the value of the move and also fall off the apparatus.
Well, yesterday we saw a mistake like this from Igor Korobchinsky in the vault, and that threw away all of his chances to break into the medals. It is about a combined score, all of the points added together, and that could quite possibly take Chusovitina out of the competition. Haley, is it possible to get a good enough score, stay in the top five?
No, there's no way she's going to make the top five now unless everybody's going to make mistakes like that, and I think it's highly unlikely in the championships of this caliber.
Chusovitina makes a big mistake on the asymmetric bars, and that could possibly mean the end of her challenge. Uzbekistan, 17-year-old, she knows there, you can see the look on her face. It's all about a combination of points. Consistency is what we're looking for to claim a medal, and let's look again in slow motion at this mistake.
Oops. There you can see she completely misses the movement, falls from the apparatus. Not only does she lose the fall, but that element was probably very important in the routine, and it means that she loses her bonus points. There with the full twisting giant into the double somersault with the full twist.
So Chusovitina, well, she's putting on a brave face. She'll look ahead now to the individual final, shakes the head there. She knows she's thrown it all away, holding back the tears. And that is a great shame. But they know the rules before they start the competition. And it really is an interesting note that you really cannot afford, as Hayley Price has pointed out to us, a poor score in any one of the four apparatus, as Gina Gojian for Romania. Now, Gojian is in fourth position, certainly featuring so far in this competition. And again, looking a little nervous, a very important second apparatus for the Romanian.
She's looking extremely good so far, and if she continues the way she started, she could be up there with the medals.
Dominique Dawes leads after her routine on the beam in the second rotation for the United States of America, with Shannon Miller, Lili of China, and Gojin the main threats as we move into the halfway point at the end of this rotation. And certainly taking a lot of careful preparation. Well, there's a disappointment, and Chusovitina has been holding back the tears, but now she sees that 8.912 drops her down into seventh position, and she'll be lucky to hold on to that placing by the end of this rotation. The competition over for the youngster from Uzbekistan.
The hardest thing for her now is to get herself together for the next two pieces of apparatus without being affected by that fall, because she really does have to concentrate.
Gina Gojian for Romania, also on the asymmetric bars, looking to break into the lead ahead of Dawes of the USA.
Here we have giant with a half into the catch-up back somersault. Swinging through into handstand. That's full twisting giant, another catch-up. building up to the dismount, which is a well-performed double somersault in the straight position.
No need, no nerves from Gojian, I should say there. And a lot of people questioned whether that second position in the European Championships just before Barcelona was the true form guide. Well, she came back with a fourth position in the Olympic Games. Fourth position also in the qualifying round for Gojian. So another interesting score. Haley, is that enough to take the lead away from Dawes?
I don't think she's going to take the lead away from Dawes. A good bar exercise, but lacking a little bit of amplitude here and there. But we'll see. Difficult to say at the moment. Here we have a very high Kachev. I think perhaps the routine didn't flow quite as well as some of the ones we've seen already.
Ludmila Stovchetaya. Reserve for the Russian team in Barcelona. So again, another gymnast that gets an opportunity to compete representing the Ukraine.
This girl looking very elegant there when she tumbles, quite tall. That's a whip into a full twisting double back somersault in the pike position. Again, showing a little bit more artistry and grace. She's a little bit older, a little bit taller as well, which quite often works well on the floor. Very nice form and shape indeed while she works. And here building up to the tumble. Cheers ran off back foot with a 2.5 twist and a counter somersault, which is a punch front out of the 2.5 twists. Could possibly lose 1/10 there for what we call concentration pause. A little bit of time wasting.
Stovchetaya, possibly a few little reminiscent moves of the great Svetlana Buginskaya, and looking to find a good balance between the tumbling and the artistry required in the floor.
There we have the 2.5 twists into the fly spring.
9.775 goes into second position, so that's a good score, but still early days in the second rotation. And the big guns from the first round and the favourites, Miller, still to come. But second position, well, she'll be very happy with that. We'll await the score now of Gojian. Now she goes second, so pushes Stovchetaya down into third. 9.812 for Gojian of Romania. Dawes still leads for the USA. Romania now second, with the Ukraine moving up into third position.
Here we have Frabnisheva again. A nice beam worker. Just waiting for the judges to signal for her to start. Once the green light comes on, she has 30 seconds to start the routine. If she doesn't start, then there will be a deduction. There's obviously some discrepancy here with the mark before. The judges are perhaps having a meeting, and that's delaying her start to the beam. Oh, we're ready to go. Starting with a very secure front somersault in the tuck position. Thank you. and into the first acrobatic series, which is the backflip and two straight back somersaults. She's working extremely confidently here. There we have a combination of acrobatic and gymnastic skills, a jump into the front somersault. Here, something quite original, the backward roll. You don't see that very often. Full spin. Series of leaps, showing her acrobatic skills. And finishing with a full twisting double back in the tuck position. Very confident beam there. One step on landing, but she'll be happy with that.
Oksana Fabrishinova, just 14 years of age, representing Russia. Not a bad start for Fabrishinova. She's lying in the top 10. Let's take a look at the technical parts of this beam work in slow motion.
There we have the three straight back somersaults. Slight loss of balance there. Deduction of perhaps 2/10. And I would say a 1/10 deduction on this landing here. We see her step to the side. But good acrobatic skills, and all the bonus marks were there.
There's certainly no shortage of support for Oksana. Plenty of cheers from the crowd there, and quite a difficult start to that routine with the music and the clapping from the audience to the floor exercise, which of course is going on at the same time.
Here we see the coach strapping up the ankle. I think in training during the week she was having problems on vault, not going particularly well, landed short and has a slight strain on the left ankle, but she's certainly coping well.
Shannon Miller for the United States of America is preparing as we go back to the Fabrishinova score. Third position, 9.750. Dominique Dawes is in first position. Gojin second. Fabrishinova third. Shannon Miller, the favorite for this competition. The second rotation, leading after the first to the beam.
Here we have the half lever lift into handstand. Into the stag split position. Into a gymnastic series of two backflips and a straight back somersault to land on 2 feet. Already into the bonus marks. That's a change leg leap. And this movement first seen by Emilienchek, the Russian gymnast who won the World Championships in 1985. Very difficult. That was a backflip to turn into handstand. Preparing for another acrobatic series. Oh, that was a mistake by Miller. She won't be happy with that. She has missed a third back somersault there. But she's pulled herself together. The pressure is certainly getting. That's the first mistake I've seen her make all week on beam. She is like a robot. Looking a little unnerved, but coping well. And the full twisting double back somersault. Again, the nerve showing. Three steps on dismount. A 0.3 deduction there for Miller. She won't be happy with that performance.
Well, like we've said, and the tears starting to appear, she looks up at the coach, and she's worked like a robot all week, and that's the first errors we've seen from Shannon Miller. She's been unbelievable till then, and the coach is trying to console Miller, who seems to be cracking under the pressure. The slow motion, Haley, very impressive until the big mistake just towards the end of the routine.
Luckily, she has the acrobatic series, gymnastic series there, rather, which she lands perfectly. This should have been a third straight back somersault. Should have been one, two straights, and a third, and she's out of line, and she misses that, and that would have been an extra 0.2 bonus for four movements in a row.
Well, we take a look again at the dismount. It's good form in the air, but the landing, again, not the perfection that we've grown used to from Miller.
And very well saved. That was almost a complete fall. That could have very easily been a complete over-rotation and a 0.5 deduction.
So the Olympic silver medalist and clear favourite for this competition has started to show a few signs of weakness in the second rotation. It will be very interesting to see this score as Dominique Dawes, her teammate, is currently in first position. And it will be a very interesting point score. Will she have done enough to take the lead in the second rotation?
Here we see Shannon Miller looking very, very disappointed with that performance, but they're concentrating already on the next piece, which will be the floor exercise.
You can almost see the mental rehearsal going through the mind there of Shannon Miller.
She is actually very self disciplined, but also analyzes her performance a great deal.
Well, there it is. She drops down into fourth position, 9.625. Well, we saw it yesterday evening in the men's. The great Vitaly Sherbo had to fight his way all the way through the first three rotations. There's only four in the women's, and already the favorite, Shannon Miller, finds herself four places lower than she was at the end of the first. So Li Li, leader of the first rotation, goes into the second, knowing the mistakes have come from Miller on one of her favorite disciplines, the floor exercise.
Here we go into the first tumble with Li Li. And she's out of the floor. That's a 0.1 deduction. And a very, very unusual start. Didn't put the double somersault in the first tumble. She's also showing signs of nerves on this floor exercise. There we have the straddle jump with a half turn. She's definitely looking rather nervous here. Tumbles haven't gone brilliantly well. She's dancing well. They're using the music well. Into the leap combination. And coming up to the third tumble. Which is the double back somersault.
Li Li of China came into this second rotation leading after the first. She'd seen the mistakes by Shannon Miller, who is now in fourth position. Dominique Dawes, also of the United States of America, is in first position. But as our expert here, Haley Price, has pointed out, Li Li looking a little nervous, possibly missing part of the first passage here.
That's the front into the full twisting front somersault. The full twisting, the forwards movements have actually been upgraded, so you know, they're difficult movements, but they weren't performed particularly well.
Well, from first to eighth position for Li Li, 9.250. So the leaderboard changes once again, and the form from the first certainly not ringing true in the second. Lysenko of the Ukraine. Well, Lysenko has started well, but the competition really has been thrown wide open.
All eyes will be on Lysenko here. She's a favorite on the floor exercise and a favorite by most of the crowd here. showing great artistry here. Very, very elegant gymnast. That's the 2.5 somersault with the punch front, slightly dodgy landing, step to the side, slight deduction. Very difficult tumbling pass. Front tumbling combination, handspring fly spring with the full twisting front, and a very dramatic finish.
Tatiana Lysenko, fourth in the European Championships, and really could have possibly seen her opportunity to break into the top three. We're still waiting to see Milicevic, who is or should be coming up on the beam. Lysenko, a lot more mature, often suffered from nerves in previous World Championship competitions. A good passage here.
That was the double Arabian somersault. And the 2.5 twist into the punch front somersault.
Well, a marker indication from one of the judges on the side of the floor there, indicating that Lysenko actually stepped out of the floor. Again, more point deductions, but we've seen a lot of point deductions so far in this second rotation. The pressure starting to show on so many of these competitors. All looking so calm and cool in the first. Well, let's move on to one of the other competitors, Lavina Milicevic of Romania. On the beam, she will have seen the upset from Shannon Miller and has the ability to break into first position.
Quite an unusual mount there by Milicevic. She's gone. She'll be disappointed. That was quite a difficult acrobatic series. The backflip into the back somersault, and she couldn't hold that landing. 0.5 deducted. That's going to set her back. The pressure's really showing here. Another loss of balance on the side somersault there. She really isn't flowing too well at all. Building up for the dismount. The double back somersault.
So the upsets continue here in the second rotation. One of the favorites. And of course, the lady who was just behind Shannon Miller in the qualification, Lavina Milicevic of Romania, has fallen in her second rotation on the beam. Will quite clearly be marked down. It'll be a low score. So Dominique Dawes, our current leader, starting to look stronger and stronger with Gojian of Romania in second position. And there is the disaster for Milicevic.
She tried to hold it, but she was completely out of line. Couldn't quite manage it. Into the double back somersault, she got herself together here for a perfect landing. But she'll certainly be disappointed with that beam exercise.
14th position, 9.337, leaves herself an awful lot to do in the final two rotations. Milicevic struggling. Dominique Dawes with the leader of the second rotation. Lysenko goes third. Well, Lysenko with 9.750 for the floor exercise we saw prior to Milicevic on the beam is in third. United States of America leads with Dominique Dors. Gojian is second for Romania. Fabricinova is third, in joint third position, I should say, with Lysenko. The surprise of the second rotation, Shannon Miller, is in fifth position. A short commercial break, and we'll be back with the second half of the Women's All-Around World Championship.
Eurosport.
Welcome back to the World Championships of Gymnastics in the Birmingham National Exhibition Centre. Well, it's been a very exciting second rotation. And the leaderboard has got the United States of America in first position. We're looking at the vault. This is the tape delay of the second rotation. We'll keep you informed as much as we can. Stovchitaya on the first vault, 9.462. With Dors, Gojian, and Lysenko in third position. Lysenko in joint third with Fabricinova.
There we see the Yuchenko vault in the straight position with a full twist.
So, Stovchitaya, I should say, gets the third rotation underway.
Slight loss of legs there, a little bend in the knees during flight, a step on landing. We've seen the vault perform better by a couple of gymnasts already. It'll be interesting to see the score. Marked out of 9.8.
First position, 9.468. Well, she's the first competitor in the third rotation, so that's to be expected. But the competition really being thrown wide open now with Milicevic and Shannon Miller both having a disaster on the beam. We really do need to pull out some tremendous scores in these final two rounds to bring themselves back into contention. Dominique Dors leads for the United States of America. And here is the lady in second position for Romania. Gina Gojian. Second in the European Championships, her best result, and looking in a very strong position to add a World Championship medal to that European picked up last summer in Nantes in France.
Another delay here. And you can see she's quite nervous. That's the front somersault mount. And a series of leaps required. Split leap into a straddle jump. Another front somersault. She's seen her friends, she's seen her rivals. She's seen them fall, and so she knows she just has to have one good routine to catch up. That was a backflip with a straight back somersault. A nice mixed combination of an acrobatic and a gymnastic skill there, a jump into a backflip. Every beam routine has to have a low element on the beam, and there we see some low movements showing her versatility. Getting ready for the big finale. She's backflip, and a double tuck back somersault. A very solid and very well performed beam exercise.
Tremendous concentration there from Gojian, with all the music and rhythmic clapping from the crowd to the floor exercise going on at the same time. So a good routine from Gojian. And as Hayley Price quite clearly pointed out, all she needed was a clean exercise there. As we look again in slow motion, she looks to have done enough to go into first position.
Quite often the case, if somebody falls on the apparatus before you and you've seen that fall, it gives you extra confidence and you know you're in there with the chance. Very well performed. Double back somersault, one step back, maybe 1/10 lost. But she should be happy with that performance.
And if you've ever seen a lady wanting her score to come as quickly as possible, it's Gina Gojian of Romania. The third rotation of four. She's in second position. Dominique Dawes is still to go, the current leader. First position, 9.725. Gojian goes into the lead and very successfully puts the pressure on the American, who is still to come, Dominique Dawes. So the tactics working wonderfully there, not doing too much, possibly tuning down the technical difficulty a little, but a good sign, and watching her other rivals very closely indeed there. We move to the floor. Oksana Fabrychanova lying in joint third position with Tatiana Lysenko of the Ukraine. So again, very important round this for the young Russian. A good performance could possibly put her into the top two.
Into the first tumble pass. That's the fulling back out in the pike position. Good landing. That's a double jump. More jumps are coming into play in gymnastics on the floor. More skills needed to add up bonus points, including jumps and spins. Very good and interesting tumble pass. That's two whip backs into the double tuck back somersault. Two whips, meaning she gets bonus points for that pass. A little bit staccato with the dance, doesn't really move an awful lot, but that's probably due to her age and lack of experience. And finishing with a double back somersault with a full twist.
Oksana Fabrychanova, just 14 years of age from Moscow. And if she can maintain that third position, will certainly be one of the surprises of this women's all-around competition. Each mark from each of the rotation is added together to give us the best overall gymnast of the four individual apparatus. Certainly the most coveted title, and another good routine for the youngster from Russia.
She'll be happy with this. She's working well. Having problems with some of these tumbles in training, and she really has got herself together in this overall competition. A stutter there. She'll lose for that. Didn't quite flow. A lot of small mistakes in this routine, but certainly working better than she did in the qualifying rounds.
Well, 23rd position was the final score of 24 finalists for Fabrice Nova. She certainly improved on that somewhat from 23rd to 3rd position coming into this third rotation. So another very interesting point score for the 14-year-old. Winner of the Moscow All-Stars competition. That was the first significant result for the youngster. And like we've said with so many of the performers here today, getting her first opportunity. There's a shot of Lily. Seemed to be limping there, Haley. Possible damage.
She came off the floor exercise limping and didn't perform particularly well. So it looks like she has an injury to her calf muscle. Again, treated with ice like all injuries are.
Well, that could spell disaster for the Chinese team. Lily, who started off with a wonderful routine on the beam to steal the lead away from Shannon Miller and possibly played a very important part in cracking the nerve of the American. And the ice bag moves on again this time. To another one of the Russian camp. Prozola Galieva there with the ice bag on the ankle. Second position moves up a spot. Fabrice Nova, 9.525. Well, the pressure is heating up once again. Gojian leads. Fabrice Nova is second. Dawes and Lysenko still to come. Shannon Miller, who's down in fifth position. Well, if she ever needed to pull out an apparatus or a performance of a lifetime, it's now for the American.
Just watch this tumbling pass. We have a whip, two backflips, and a full twisting back somersault. And she makes it look extremely easy. Very lively music, interprets it well. She's very elfin-like, and she's working well to the music. Here we have two whips, three whips into a double twist. I think floor perhaps one of her favourite pieces. Building up for the final tumble pass. Again, the fulling back out. Nice jump combination of spin at the end. Very well executed.
Well, a new routine for Shannon Miller. Different from that of Barcelona. And she starts the long and arduous comeback from fifth position, hopefully to get into the medals and possibly snatch back that first placing in the fourth and final. Well, certainly a difference in the facial expression from Shannon Miller after that very disappointing routine on the beam. She draws on all of the experience and inner strength to work a very enjoyable but also very skillful floor routine.
Here we go into, I think, the middle tumbling pass, which is the whip, another whip, a third whip, into the double twisting somersault. She certainly has to be small to fit in all those movements. Getting bonus marks for that pass as well. Finishing, again, great energy at the end of the routine, being able to finish with a full twisting double back somersault.
Well, again, the very painstaking wait for the scores from Shannon Miller. There's a good example of the shorthand used by these judges, explained earlier by our resident expert here at Eurosport. Well, Shannon Miller, 16 years of age, and she's done it. The crowd erupt and are screaming for Shannon Miller. 9.825, and she's back on top of the leaderboard. Shannon Miller, Well, they say when the going gets tough, the tough get going, and she certainly has proved that. Miller has gone from fifth to first position. Gozian is second. Fabrishinova is in third position. But of course, the lady leading the second rotation has yet to compete in the third, and that is the teammate of Shannon Miller, Dominique Dawes. So we will keep our eyes focused very closely indeed. Has Miller done enough, or will Dominique Dawes retain first position? Stella Rumet there of Canada, and closely watched by mum in the crowd. She was cheering her on in the qualifications throughout start to finish. As we move into the second half of the third rotation, if you've just joined us, this is live action from the World Championships in the National Exhibition Centre of Birmingham. Looking a little concerned. But Hayley, very interesting floor routine for Stella Rumet.
Yes, it's a very rhythmical routine, very unusual music, which you'll hear in just a moment. And she interprets it very well.
No shortage of support for the Canadian. In eighth position, Rumet, the floor in the third rotation.
Here we go into the first tumble, the double straight back somersault. That is an E element for the girl gymnast. Very difficult move, and bonus marks rewarded for that. Nice jump sequence, powerful gymnast. Very few people could get away with this music, but she does use it well. There we have the full twist in front into a punch front somersault. Good combination. With a double back somersault, double twisting somersault rather, and an unusual ending.
Well, the crowd certainly enjoying that one, and of course applause from the family and mom in the crowd there. But a very unique and interesting routine for Stella Rumet of Canada. It'll be an interesting to see how the judges score that. Rumet, like Shannon Miller, really does require a very high score if she's to be in contention for the medals going into the fourth rotation.
There we saw a well-landed double straight back somersault. Not too many of the girls performing that movement. Very, very difficult indeed. There we have the whip salto into the double twist.
Once again, a painstaking wait for Stella Rumet as Tatiana Lysenko. Well, as we reach the second half of this third rotation, she was lying in third position. Miller and Gozhin, first and second position.
There we have the first 10 tariff vault of the evening. That is a Yuchenko with a double twist. Very well performed, good flight, good legs. But just one step on landing.
So the degree of difficulty of the highest. And possibly Hayley Lysenko seizing the opportunity to try and steal the lead away from Miller.
Looking here to make up the mark, she knows that vault is one of her strongest pieces. What she needs to do is repeat that vault for a good average mark. There we see the two twists. Cartwheel onto the board. Very impressive vaulting.
Well, Lysienko, who took the bronze medal in the vault in the individual apparatus, will look to repeat that score and will surely go into first position ahead of Shannon Miller of the United States of America.
And that's even better. She'll be happy with that. Again, the Yurchenko with a double twist.
So Tatiana Lysenko representing the Ukraine. Picked up that bronze medal in Barcelona, of course, representing the unified team. Each of the Eastern European gymnasts representing their newly formed republics. And that really was a wonderful second vault. And certainly showing no signs of nerves where so many are faltering. Lysienko seems to be going from strength to strength throughout this competition.
Again, the cartwheel onto the board. Good hike, good flight, and a better landing. Lysenko is believed to have arrived with a shoulder injury, but it certainly isn't showing today.
And there is the score, and as we anticipated, Tatiana Lysenko for the Ukraine goes into first position, 9.824, and Miller is now second, Gauthier is in third position. Stella Ume goes into 11th position with a score of 9.300, respectable for the Canadian. She finished in 17th position in the World Championships 2 years ago. First look at the other Canadian representative here in the final, Stacey Galloway.
That's the straight Yurchenko vault with a full twist. The same vault as we've just seen, but with only one twist, not the two. Marked out of 9.8. And performed tidily. Good flight, good distance, but a 1/10 deduction for her landing.
Rosalia Kalieva. Ooh, and a very lucky escape there going onto the beam.
Again, the two straight back somersaults, giving her that extra bonus. Nice leap combination, split leap, pike jump. The girls are having to add more combinations with their leaps and jumps to gain extra marks. Good front somersault in the tuck shape. I think that's the first free walkover we've seen this evening. Very well performed. Again, a mixed combination of acrobatic and gymnastic skills. And finishing with a full in back out in the pike position.
Galieva really has looked very focused and serious about this.
that, the acrobatic series again we saw, the backflip and two straight back somersaults. Lacking in rotation on the dismount, but managing to save it without a fall.
Stella Ume, 9.7, 13th position for her floor exercise. Well, she'll be looking to finish certainly above as we go to the second vault of Stacey Gulloway. And as I was saying, Ume certainly hoping to finish higher than she did in the Indianapolis Championships of 91.
And again, the straight for twisting Yurchenko. Very similar vault to the first one. With a sidestep on landing, and I think we'll be looking at a similar score. Slightly low on flight and legs slightly coming apart.
So the second of the Canadians, Stacey Gulloway, goes into 16th position with her teammate Stella Ume in 13th. Galieva goes fifth, that's respectable, 9.575. Well, let's hope she goes two places better and gives us a smile at the end. But this is the one lady that we really do need to focus on. And this will be the deciding of the top five going into the last rotation. This rotation number three, Dominic Dawes, current leader of the second with her floor exercise.
That's a full in back out. Just watch this girl, she can tumble. Full of energy. There we have the popper, which was done by a Romanian gymnast. And again, the straddle jump with a turn. Very lively music to suit her personality. Just watch this. Whip, whip. And the double twisting somersault straight into a punch front, immediately into a double back somersault. And the crowd are really enjoying this. Double spin. Again, we see the straddle jump. You can see all the gymnasts adding these extra jumps again here. Any way they can get bonus marks, they'll be doing it. Final tumble pass. Two and a half somersaults, very difficult and perfectly landed. She's going to be happy with this.
Well, smiles and applause from both Dominique Dawes and the crowd. And if there was ever a time to put out one of your best routines, it was now. And surely Dominique Dawes has gone into first position in the third rotation with one fourth and final set of apparatus to come. Dominique Dawes, who's been in the shadow of Shannon Miller throughout the qualification, possibly a clever move by this young 16-year-old. And Dominique Dawes here, really sensational tumbling.
Here we go, into the full in back out. She has endless energy and that actually admits it herself. She can't stop. Two whip overs into a double twisting back somersault, immediately into a third tumbling pass, finishing with a double tuck back somersault. Here we see in slow motion the end tumble, the two and a half twists, very difficult to land and perfectly executed.
Well, Dominique Dawes has certainly seen that the opportunity is there. The gold medal is out for the grabbing, thanks to, or not good news for the Americans, but the mistakes have come from Shannon Miller. And Dominique Dawes has given us a floor routine full of personality, artistry, and some of the most sensational tumbling skills we've seen so far at this competition here in Birmingham. Surely we'll go into first position at this point in the competition. Lysienko, Miller, Gozhian, and there we have it, 9.80. Dominique Dawes for the United States of America has gone into first position. Lysenko is now second and Miller is third. My oh my, what a battle in the fourth and final rotation. The standings after three of four rounds in this women's all-around world championship competition. Dominique Dawes is one, Lysenko is two for the Ukraine. Shannon Miller with it all to do in the fourth and final round is third. Gozhian looking to get in the medals is fourth. And Fabrichinova looking for her first world championship medal. A short commercial break here on Eurosport and we will be back with the finale and the medals of this women's all-around championship. Welcome back to live action here on Eurosport and the fourth and final round of the women's all-around competition. Stella Ume, well, I think that's the warm-up. Yes, they're warming up in preparation there. It's very exciting. We're right on the edge of our seats here as to get the fourth and final rotation underway. Oksana Fabrichinova, she's lying in fifth position. So a good routine here and a few mistakes from the top three could give this youngster from Russia the possibility of a world championship medal. It is so close between the top five. Anything could happen. So stay with us over the next 40 minutes to decide who will be the world all-around champion of 1993. First away in the vault, the first of two, Fabrichinova.
There we see the Yuchenko vault again. Full twisting Yuchenko in the straight position in 9.8 tariff. Not a good landing. Needs to perfect that landing in the second vault to score a good average. Again, nice tidy legs with two, maybe three steps even on landing. A definite 2/10 loss there on the landing. Good distance though for such a short girl. Covers a lot of ground there.
Well, Fabrichinova certainly needs two perfect scores. 9.550. Well, it's respectable, but possibly not enough. Bar a disaster from the top four to break into the top three and a medal position. Let's see if this young 14-year-old can improve on the second.
She changed the vault. She actually added another twist in there. Performing the double twist in Yuchenko, marked out of a 10 tariff. She's the first girl to change her vault in the overall championships. Here we see, good flight on one, two twists, and it was a better landing. Slight deviation, but good tactics, changing her vault and performing it even better than the first.
Fabrichinova possibly sensing that she needs to do a little more if she's to become a threat. This is the fourth and final rotation. Four sets of apparatus rather than six, which we saw in the men's competition yesterday evening. Vitaly Sherbo. Good plan there, Haley. She goes into first position, 9.643, and the point score, certainly. Maybe she should have done that second vault on the first.
Very good tactics there. I think she should have warmed up with the first one and then went for it on the second one.
Well, Shannon Miller. She is not only vaulting to put herself into first position here, but she possibly needs the best vault of her career to take gold. She's been favourite. The pressure has been upon her from start to finish. Miller vaulting in the last rotation for the World Championship of 93.
And she can certainly work under pressure. It's a perfect landing. Only a 9.8 vault. You can see Fabrizianova there putting the extra twist in to put pressure on Miller. But that was very well executed with a solid landing. Here we see cartwheel onto the horse, onto the board, and a perfect landing. Possibly the best full twist in Yurchenko that we've seen this evening.
The first vault, 9.775, going to plan for Shannon Miller. The second is vital to give us the aggregate score. No shortage of supporters in the crowd for the American.
She needs to produce the same type of vault again. And she's done it again. Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant.
Well, the smiles from Shannon Miller. At last, she shows the emotion that's been close to tears after the disaster in the beam. The coach is pleased. And will it be enough? We'll have to wait right until the end of the competition to see Shannon Miller has possibly pulled it off in the fourth and final rotation. The coach says that's the one we were looking for. And Hayley, two perfect vaults from Miller under a tremendous amount of pressure.
I think that just shows all the hard work and training she's done to work under that amount of pressure and produce vaults like that is incredibly, incredibly difficult. There, the distance she lands away from the horse. Superb line, excellent technique.
First position, 9.787, but of course she was third going into this fourth and final rotation. She will wait very carefully indeed to see Lysenko and Dawes in a better position than her after the third rotation. Stella Ume of Canada, she's in 13th position, looking to improve on her personal best from the World Championships of 2 years ago, of a 17th position.
See, the straight full twist in Yurchenko, but we've just seen Miller perform it almost perfectly, and that wasn't quite as well performed technically. Movement in landing. Here we see it in slow motion. Loses her legs there, slightly apart on takeoff and small step backwards.
Vault number two for Ume, 9.637. No shortage of encouragement from Mom.
Again, just lacking a little bit on flight. Slightly apart again when hitting the top of the horse with her hands. Very, very difficult to see this vault perform better than Miller, so I'm being very critical here.
Salarume goes into fifth position. Early days in the fourth rotation, 9.637. Shannon Miller puts the tracksuit on. Steve Nuno, the coach, giving her a few possibly relaxing nerves, but she's got to watch carefully now. Dominique Dawes is still to come as we move to the asymmetric bars to catch up with Tatiana Lysenko. She's ahead of Miller coming into this fourth rotation. She was lying in second position just behind Dominique Dawes. She needs to score just above 9.7, and she will go into first position and deny Shannon Miller of the USA the gold medal, the World Championship of 93. No shortage of support for Tatiana Lysenko of the Ukraine. Possibly the most important asymmetric bar routine of this young Ukrainian's life.
Flying back to catch the top bar. Into the Jaeger somersault. Slightly loses her legs there. Slight bend of the knees. Full twisting giant. And the blind change into a very interesting dismount. That's a back away. Front somersault rather, not a back away. A front somersault with a half turn.
Well, Lysenko has the advantage over Shannon Miller. So, as we said earlier, every point really does count here. Well, we're hearing screams from the crowd. I think that's to say that Milicevic will be the next to vault.
Here again. Flying back to catch the top bar. That's a hop change into a very, very high Jaeger somersault. Full twisting giant. And there we see the double front somersault with the half turn.
This will decide first and second position. Miller leads for the United States of America. Lysenko looking to put the Ukraine into first position. Shannon Miller literally looking for anything to do rather than wait for the score. Are you looking for Lysenko waits patiently. The judges finalizing, putting their scores together. Has Miller done enough to stay in first position with doors still to come? Or has Lysenko denied gold to Shannon Miller, the favourite from start to finish of this competition? Painstaking wait for these gymnasts. Tatiana Lysenko. Oh, we thought the score was going to arrive. A few boos from the crowd. That could spell bad news for Lysenko. We are literally in the hands of the judges here. Second position, it's not enough. 9.725. Lysenko has not denied Shannon Miller in the fourth and final apparatus. Disappointment for the young 16-year-old from the Ukraine. Shannon Miller has done enough, lives one life, but there is another one to go. The lady who's quite clearly ahead, Dominique Dawes. Now she has quite a large advantage. Dominique Dawes will have two vaults. These two vaults, if go to plan, will surely give this young 16-year-old the surprise of the American team from start to finish. The gold medal in the all-around title of 93. Well, just to tempt you even more, Miller, Lysenko, Fabrichinova, Milicevic still to come in fourth position. Remember, Milicevic is the Olympic and world vault champion, and Li Li of China fifth. Three medals, unfortunately, is what it's all about. as we will return to the two vaults of Dominique Dawes. Miller has seen Lysenko off. Can she see her teammate away in the fourth and final rotation? Leader after the second rotation. Leader after the third. Fourth and final round. The warm-up for the other gymnasts comes to an end. And this will be very important. Well, just a warm-up for Dominique Dawes. That's not the official one. We'll wait for the graphic. And Haley, Dominique Dawes really looking very composed considering what this final two vaults are all about.
Yeah, she's been cool all the way through. Let's hope she can stay cool and produce two good vaults, because she's in there with a chance and certainly wasn't favourite to win.
So the warm-up as we move into the second half of the vault, and quite rightly our cameras focusing on the one lady that can change the standings. Anya Portondu for Cuba. I think it really is a great step forwards for the Cuban Gymnastic Federation to have Anya competing here this year. Again, first vault. And Haley, very difficult indeed for these gymnasts to focus and concentrate on each of the apparatus while there can be so much excitement and crowd attention with the floor routines.
You really have to shut off all the other competitors, all the other noise going on in the arena, and just concentrate on what you're doing. And experience helps, but it's difficult to do sometimes, but you just concentrate on your piece. That was a Yurchenko again we saw there by the Cuban. Again in the straight position and again with a full twist. As you can see, a very popular vault, hence it's gone down to 9.8.
9.612 for Portondu. The second vault. And really any result in this final is a personal best for Anya. First ever major championship qualification. Her goals will change and go forwards another stage after this evening's competition.
And she's chosen to do the same vault again, a little bit short on landing. Slight step forwards. Here we see again in slow motion. A good vault, apart from the step on landing. Good height, good legs, a fair distance away from the horse, but loses her upper body on landing.
Sixth position for Portondo, early days in the fourth rotation. But the fourth rotation really is all about deciding the 1, 2, and 3. Miller and Lysenko in first and second position. And finally, Dominique Dawes of the United States of America. The crowd have warmed to this personable 16-year-old from start to finish, working with a different coach to Shannon Miller. This is her last apparatus of the evening. I'm trying to stay as calm as I possibly can, because this two vaults will decide who is the gold medalist. Miller is waiting in first position. Lysenko is in second for the Ukraine. Dawes, vault number one.
There we see a different vault. We have another Yurchenko, but this time with a 1.5 twist.
Well, quite clearly a small step forwards on the landing there. Every point really does count now.
difficult vault to do. Anything landing forwards is always difficult to land. Slight loss of legs, we see it in slow motion. Slight bend of the knees. And just loses a balance slightly on landing.
Dominic Dawes eager to get the second one underway there before we've seen the score of the first. Just rehearsing each and every movement. And look at Shannon Miller there.
She is actually performing a 10 tariff vault here. So again, going for that higher tariff.
9.712. Dominic Dawes now will risk everything for a World Championship gold medal on the second vault, looking to deny teammate Shannon Miller. Still a medalist in Barcelona, Dominic Dawes, who really has been the surprise. And there is an indication the supporters really have grown to this young 16-year-old. And this is the jump that will decide it. Dawes for the USA at grabs World Championship gold.
That has blown it. That has blown it. Again, I mentioned the 1.5 twist, one of the most difficult vaults to land.
It's okay. You gave it a good shot.
She's disappointed.
When did you ever think you would be?
Well, tears from Dominic Dawes, and there's a few tears in the commentary box, I can assure you. What a shame. Try to be cheered up and not to be too disappointed by the coach, but my oh my, what a shame. Dominic Dawes has thrown it away. On the final vault, we'll wait for the total score, but surely it will not be enough. And Shannon Miller, on the last vault, is the first to congratulate, to be congratulated by Dominic Dawes. She'd done enough on the first vault as well. And Hayley, that's probably one of the saddest climaxes to any gymnast world championships. 9.493 is the score. And third position, Shannon Miller takes gold after one of the most difficult competitions she will ever challenge. Lysenko has gone second, and disappointment and tears for Dominic Dawes in third place.
Well, I think that's the first time I've actually been stuck for words. That was a big shock. She was up there with a chance. She was the underdog of the competition. And as the coach pointed out, when did she ever think she was going to be anywhere near the title? But she's disappointed, and two teammates, it's got to be tough.
Well, she wasn't tipped to even qualify for this. She came as the third member of the American team and was the surprise to qualify. As we move on now to Rosalia Galieva on the floor. This really now, bar an amazing turnout, the result will stand, and Shannon Miller seems to have done enough. That will not deter Galieva from enjoying her final rotation.
Perfect double straight back somersault there. One of the most difficult movements on the floor for women. And she's got the crowd behind her. Nice series of jumps. There we see the handspring, full twist in front, immediate punch front somersault in the tuck position. And being interpreted well, and the crowd there behind her enjoying the music too. Building up to the final tumble. It's the pulling back out, and she stepped out of the floor. That's 1/10 lost. But well landed, unfortunate mistake.
Galieva, the 15-year-old representing Uzbekistan. Clearly noting there, she knows she stepped out. And really the spatial awareness of these gymnasts is incredible. Every inch of that floor is within their mind. It's almost a second sense when the gymnast steps out that they know inside they've done just that.
I think here we're going to see the last tumble. If you look closely, we'll see her left foot, I think, is out of the floor. It's very, very close.
9.637, fifth position for Galieva. The 1, 2, and 3, USA, Ukraine, and USA. Miller, Lysenko, and Dawes unchanged with just a few competitors to go. Well, one lady that could change that third position and turn those tears into misery for Dominique Dawes is Gina Gojian for Romania. She comes into this fourth and final rotation lying in fourth position. Again, perfect floor exercise here, and she could claim a bronze medal. Silver medalist in the European Championships, and it really would prove that form guide and be a wonderful season as Miller at last has started to relax. She knows that she's got it, but it's not over, and Gojian could once again change those medal positions. European champion on the floor in the individual exercise. She scored 9.92. A score like that today would certainly put her into first position, so we'll watch this one very carefully. Can the Romanian spoil the party of the Americans currently lying in gold and bronze medal position?
Having to wait such a long time to begin is obviously making her nervous.
Well, the individual European champion on the floor. She's given 101% to try and claim a world championship medal. And after all that tumbling, nearly trips over walking off the floor.
Put a smile to her face. That's usually the way accidents happen in gymnastics.
Wonderful tumbling as we take a look again in the passage in slow motion.
Whip back somersault into a series of flicks, and my mistake, it wasn't the double back, it was a full in back out in the first tumble. We saw three sets of double backs, one full in back out, one combination with a double back, and ending with the double back somersault. Again, the whip combination, double tucked back somersault.
So once again, we find ourselves awaiting the score. Very patiently, has the Romanian done enough to claim a medal, or will she finish this competition in fourth position? There's Dominique Dawes. Gojian gets the congratulations from the teammates, but we'll wait very carefully. Miller seems to have done enough to claim the gold. The celebrations are already beginning here in the National Exhibition Centre. We're waiting for one final score. Has the Romanian done enough, as the athletes have to make a march off the arena, and then we'll come back onto the arena for the presentation ceremony. And of course, the presentation of the awards. And she's done it. How about that? 9.800. And Gojian at last smiles. The last score of the competition. The last competitor has gone from fourth to silver medal. Lysenko has to settle for the bronze, and a very lucky escape for Shannon Miller. And it really has been quite a lucky day for the American. Shannon Miller has taken the gold. Gojian, the European champion, takes a silver in the World Championships, and Lysenko from the Ukraine takes the bronze, and a tear or two will be shed this evening for young Dominique Dawes of the United States of America. She'd done enough on the first vault, and on that second vault, just had the little tumble, landed on the backside, and it all went away, disappeared. Take nothing away from Gina Gojian. She's done enough in the final exercise of the floor to claim the silver medal. Very entertaining all-around competition here in the National Exhibition Centre in Birmingham. And it really has been exciting from start to finish. Shannon Miller starting off so well, then losing form in the middle. We've been on the edge of our seats right until the end. Hayley, for you, the best point in this competition, all from start to finish. Pretty nerve-wracking, to say the least.
I think one of the most exciting points of this competition was Dawes, although, you know, she wasn't expected to be anywhere near the medals. And I think that's what really made it an exciting competition. We see some brilliant gymnastics. Unfortunate for Dominique, but Miller has worked well through the training session. She's worked well through the year and truly does deserve the championships.
Possibly we were a little hard on Shannon Miller, but it all started to fall apart with that disaster on the beam. But as Hayley Price, our expert here in the commentary box, pointed out, the true sign of a champion, she really does work like a robot. We've read and we've heard that when she's not training 6 to 7 hours a day, Shannon Miller has brought all of her homework to study while she's here. It really is non-stop work for this American, and at last she has paid dividends. She didn't take gold in Barcelona, was there pushed into second place by the great Tatiana Gutsu. Gutsu was not here in Birmingham for the World Championships. So Miller steps up, the form book is kept true, and Shannon Miller is the 1993 all-around world champion. The gymnasts have marched off, and we will have a presentation, as on your screens, the official result. Lysenko being pushed down, disappointing for Dominique Dawes. Fabrichinova of Russia, a good fifth position, as Galieva and Pwiskin in sixth and seventh, and a little disappointing for Milicevic of Romania, only down in eighth place. And if you like your mathematical statistics, 0.07 separating first and second position. Li Li of China in ninth position. She started off with a wonderful beam exercise, but of course, that being her specialist discipline of the four, couldn't really move on from there. And a very pleasing result for the Cuban Gymnastic Association. Potumdo coming in 10th position. Josefitina, little disappointing, representing Uzbekistan for the first time. And moving down to Everard of Belgium, personal best for her in 22nd position. Galloway, 21st, another personal best. He, 24th, the last of the 24 finalists for China. But the day has gone to the United States of America. First and fourth position, Shannon Miller has taken the gold. And the crowd tell the story. Well, it really has been pleasant to see. They've cheered every one of these finalists along from start to finish. But no words from the commentary box. The answer is on your screen. So we await the presentation ceremony of this final. And Shannon Miller, who made one of possibly the most historical comebacks in gymnastics. But I have to say, That gold medal would have not have been Miller's, was it not for Dominique Dawes. She seemed, Haley, so confident from start to finish throughout the competition, and on the last vault of the evening, it all slipped by. Nerves or a genuine mistake?
I think a little bit of both. I think a little bit of pressure and a little bit of nerves, but also perhaps lacking in rotation and a mistake easily made on that kind of vault. A 10 tariff vault, going for difficulty, and unfortunately it didn't work.
So as the 24 finalists re-emerge into the national arena here at Birmingham, the all-around titles have been decided. Sherbo taking gold for the men, for Belarusia, I should say. And Miller claiming gold for the United States of America. Leads the parade back to the arena. Shannon Miller marching very proudly indeed to the anthem of the championships. Just behind her, Romania's Gina Gojian and Lysenko. And what a shame for Dominique Dawes just behind there in fourth position. But Haley, always a smile from Dominique, and surely one of the future talents of American gymnastics.
Dominique's a really nice character. She works hard, she criticizes herself a lot, but she's always got a smile for people, and I think she's been a very popular person of this championship.
Well, not only smiles from Shannon Miller, but Steve Nuno, the coach of Shannon Miller, who really has been a guiding light to Miller throughout, and possibly, Haley, played a very important role in remotivating and refocusing Miller's confidence off that very disappointing second rotation.
Yes, he always appears quite intense and quite aggressive, but I think it works, and he certainly knows how to talk around and how to get the adrenaline flowing and get her concentration back where it should be.
Well, I hope that the United States of America is getting these pictures here from Birmingham, because a 16-year-old from Edmond in Oklahoma has certainly put the USA back on top. And interesting to note that the United States of America successfully defends the world title. Kim Zemeskal was the victor here in 1991. Of course, that was back on home soil in Indianapolis. And from Kim Zemeskal to Shannon Miller.
Norbert Bosch, le secrétaire général de la Fédération internationale de gymnastique, Monsieur Jeffrey Bott, le président du comité d'organisation, et Monsieur Patrick Borel, directeur général de France Télécom au Royaume-Uni.
Well, that's the end to a breathtaking finale. First of all, can I introduce the presentation party? Mr. Jim Barry, Senior Vice President of the FIG. Round of applause. Norbert Bosch, Secretary General, FIG.
International Committee are
Chairman
introduced.
Of the Organizing Committee. Also,
Milicevic at the end of the line there. And Milicevic will be back, you can guarantee, in the vault. Of course, still a weekend of live gymnastics action ahead on Eurosport, with the individual apparatus still to come.
World Gymnastics Championships. With a score of 39.062 from USA, Shannon Miller.
Shannon Miller claims the gold, the all-around champion of 1993. And certainly one of the most difficult battles she's had in her career to date.
I think we're about to see the first show of emotion we've seen during the whole championship from Miller.
Silver position there, announced.
From the Ukraine, Tatiana Lysenko.
Gojian takes the silver medal, and Lysenko, a good, consistent performance from her.
We now invite the presentation party to give the gymnast.
Seventh in Barcelona, and moves up into third position.
Barry, Senior Vice President of the FIG, will present the gold medal to Sharon Miller. Shannon Miller. Norbert Bosch to Gina Gojian, and Mr. Jeffrey Bott, the bronze medal to Tatiana Lysenko. And in fourth place is Dominique Dawes, who will receive a scroll from the USA.
Well, there's a huge round of applause for Dominique Dawes.
From Russia. In sixth,
Galieva, sixth position for Uzbekistan.
Yelena Piskun from Belarus.
Belarusia.
And in eighth, Piskun. Milosevic from Romania.
And Milosevic, who I'm sure will come back to contend individual gold and once again battle it out with Shannon Miller and Dominique Dawes over the weekend. And the crowd really cheering.
Our presentation party to present
thoroughly enjoying this competition. Well, Sherbo, on Thursday evening, Friday evening, it is Shannon Miller. Some new names to look forward to the future. Some names of the past. World champion of 1993, Shannon Miller for the United States.
Of the new world champion.
Well, I'm sure you'll agree that's a classic competition, a true world championship test and battle. Shannon Miller stands very proudly, as there's a few tears in the crowd there, for the champion of 1993 in the all-around title.
Telecom trophy to the winner, Shannon Miller.
Well, we've come to the end of our coverage from Birmingham a little earlier than expected here on Eurosport. They've certainly finished over half an hour before the scheduled running order. That gives us the opportunity after this women's all-around competition to give you the highlights of yesterday's men's all-around competition. So a feast of gymnastics for you this evening on Eurosport. After this break, we'll be back with the fifth and sixth rotation of the men's all-around competition last evening. From Nick Fellows and Hayley Price, we look forward to joining you on Saturday and Sunday for the finale of the World Championships.